Welcome back to Booze and Rocks. My name is David Edwards. Today, I got a date with a couple of pink ladies. Let's see if they're any good together. Alrighty, it's great to have every one of you back here today. We have a date with the pink ladies. What I'm going to do is I'm going to make two different versions of this cocktail for you, and let's see how they turn out. Now, the original cocktail is a pre-prohibition cocktail. It was first written down in the 1913 Manual of Mixed Drinks by Jacques Straub. And we didn't see it again in print until the 1930 Savoy Cocktail book by Harry Craddock. In that cocktail, they actually removed the Applejack and put in some egg white for it to smooth it out. However, we do feel that this cocktail was named after Hazel Dawn. Now, she was an early actress, and she played the part of the Pink Lady in a musical by Ivan Carroll. Anyways, yeah, you know what? That's enough of the history. You know, we just really want to get into the actually into the cocktails. Who cares about the history today? You know what? So we're gonna make the first one, and I'm using differedguide.com's recipe for this. So the first thing I need is my shaking glass. The next thing you need is some gin, and you want a dry gin. So I'm using Devil's Keep Distillery gin. This is a Canadian gin, and we need 1.5 ounces. The good thing about this gin is you get a whole heck of a lot of pine and juniper scent. So I really, really like it. 1.5 ounces is 45 milliliters. The next thing you'll need is, of course, your Applejack of choice. In this case, I have some Laird's Applejack brandy. And I guess I should have opened it first. However, it spins quite nicely and it allows me to use a knife and pretend like I look like I know what I'm doing knife-wise, which apparently this should really be at the end of the... all right, well, good enough. Let's try this again. So I need 1/2 ounce of this, which works out to 15 mils. Let's give this a bit of a... Oh, you can smell the apples coming off this. Oh, you know what? I can get the first taste out of this bottle. Oh, that's good. Laird's Applejack, everybody. It's a smooth blend. Anyways, we need 15 mils, which is 1/2 ounce. The next thing we'll need is 0.4 ounce of simple syrup. And that works out to roughly 17.5 mils. So that's about right. We also need a little bit of grenadine. And I'm using a homemade grenadine. This is a 1-to-1 grenadine syrup. You know, one part pomegranate juice, one part sugar. Cook it down, add a cap full of an orange liqueur of your choice, or a couple of drops of orange flower water if you have it where you are. The good thing about the orange liqueur is if this will now last a little bit longer. And we need 5 mils, which is our bar spoon. Now there's one more thing that we need for this particular version of the cocktail. We need 3/4 ounce of lemon juice. Now, interestingly enough, this is a lot more like a sour than a sweet and savory drink. And what did I say we needed? 3/4 ounce, which is 22.5 mils. You would think by now I would know how to be able to do that in the top back of my head, but David struggles some days. And last but not least, we need some egg white. So grab your egg, throw it in the air, try not to break it, give it a slight crack, oops, like that, and open it up. Don't waste your little bit of egg yolk, drink it. Mmm, yum. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna shake this. And we're gonna shake this first with ice for about 10 to 15 seconds. Then we're going to shake it again without ice. So bear with me as I make a bunch of noise. Slam it down, make sure it's nice and solid and straight, flip it over, slap your thumb on there, and away we go. Slap it with the power of 1,000 suns. What we're gonna do is we're just gonna take the ice out of this now, so we'll just pour this like so. Get rid of the ice. And we'll shake this again really, really hard because we want this to foam a little bit nicer. And again for another 10 seconds. Whew, that's a lot of shaking. However, move this over. Choose your glass of choice. In my case, I'm going to use a nice little classic fancy coupe glass. It's nice, it's pretty, it's evocative of a pre-prohibition cocktail age. And you know what? Let's fine strain this. And look at that. Absolutely gorgeous. You can't go wrong with that. Not quite as pink as I thought it would have been, but that's because of the very small amount of the grenadine. However, we're gonna garnish this. Now, this usually requires a maraschino cherry, and what I'll do is I'll grab one of my fancy cherries just because I like them. These still have the stems. Awesome syrup. Mm. Give the bottom a bit of a slice. Put this like so right there. And you know what? I went out into my garden and I got some lemon balm as I'm all minted out. And you know what? Let's put just this little bit right here. And I think that looks quite pretty. What do you think? Nice, delicate, fancy looking. Okay, let's move this over here. Now we're gonna get to the next version of the Pink Lady. Grab your shaking glass or shaking tin, whatever version you wanna start with. Move the knife out of your way so you don't hurt yourself. Always an important thing. First thing you'll do, grab an ounce and a half of gin. So again, this is another one of those gin forward cocktails. And we will add in an ounce and a half, which is 45 mils. Next, but not least, is half and half. You could use a heavier cream if you want. You don't have to. Again, your personal preference. This is another ounce and a half of this as well. Doesn't look very pink to me, does it?
No.
However, now you're gonna take your homemade grenadine again, and you're gonna put in half an ounce. Half an ounce is 15 mils. Now it's gonna be pink. If I need to add more, I will. You know, we'll make it pink. Throw some ice in there, another 10 to 15 seconds. Try and actually keep the ice in there and the juice while you're at it. Now, give it a shake like you wouldn't believe. Pop that off. That's not very pink. Let's add a little bit more. Bit more of a shake just to incorporate it. Because after all, if it's not pink, it's not a pink lady. Dry your hands off, clean off your table, and grab something else that looks kind of fancy. Look at that. And now, grab your Hawthorne strainer, fire this down like so. Nearly lost it there. How does that look? So grab one of your nuclear red cherries, because this is the one you're gonna see at the bar. This is most likely the version that you will see at a bar. You know what, let's grab two of these because they're just so darned pretty. Actually, you know what? They're not super pretty, but grab your cocktail pin, jam it in there like so. Look at that. There we have another Pink Lady. Absolutely gorgeous, maybe. Not quite as gorgeous as this one. Hold on, look at that. So let's give them a taste. So the first one we smell, we can smell the gin and we can smell the apple And of course, we get a little bit, excuse me, the lemon balm directly off the scent of these. I'm making a mess. You know what? This is good. Oh, it's a very alcohol forward cocktail. The apple comes through. The gin and the large Applejack work really, really well together. The lemon juice and the simple syrups and the grenadine absolutely work well. It's not as pink as you would think. And that rhymed, haha. But, oh yeah, look at that. The next thing we're gonna try is your standard bar, Pink Lady. Let's see what we think. Well, I really don't get the smell of gin from it. Of course, that would be trapped by all the cream and the grenadine. Apparently I need to trim my mustache. Not bad. You can taste the gin more on its own. It's more gin forward. If you wanted this to be a little creamier, I would go with a whipping cream. It would just give you a little bit more of a cream consistency and would probably hold up a little bit better in my opinion. However, it's still a good drink. Let's be honest, I'd rather have this. This is a much better cocktail. Better refined, better taste. You get the edges of the sour. Oh yeah. This one by Difford's Guide. Simon Difford, you make a good cocktail. I must admit that. Tell me which one you think you would like better. Leave a comment down below. If this is your first time to my channel, please make sure you hit the subscribe button and that bell notification. That way, every time you put up a new video, I put up a new video, you will be notified. I'm struggling now. And if you'd like to support the channel, please check us out on patreon.com/boozeontherocks. Every little bit helps to help bring this content out to you when I'm not screwing up all the time. You know what? Thank you very much. Give these two thumbs up and we'll see you next time. Welcome back to Booze and Rocks. My name is David Edwards. Today, we have a date with a couple of... Fuck. And it originally is seen in 1913. This is a pre-prohibition cocktail, and it's originally first written down in Jacques